Meeting to order. Welcome to the December 2016 board meeting, our last board meeting of the year. It's called to order. The Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we have minutes from October. I'm sure you've all read them. So if there are no additions, deletions, or corrections, we have a motion for approval.
So moved.
Second.
A motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Public, opposed say nay. Okay, public input. In the interest of Mr. Trancheck getting to the airport on time, Mr. Trancheck, would you care to address us?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm actually here to supplement Ms. Eagan's report on the Cross Bay Ferry, so I guess we're going to kind of ad lib this. We're all friends here. Just to kind of provide an update on Cross Bay Ferry stats, and we've been working with HART staff. Steve and I have talked a couple marketing meetings together. The first month of the ferry has been really positive on weekends. In the month of November, we averaged close to 1,200 riders Friday, Saturday, Sunday. That's 56% of capacity. And for one little boat that could, it's doing an awful lot. The busiest day is Saturday. Sunday is the second busiest, and Friday is the lightest. The schedule on Friday was a little lean of dwell time in St. Petersburg, so there was a schedule adjustment to provide more dwell time. So the boats coming here earlier in Tampa and going to St. Pete earlier, they spend a little bit more time, and then about 2.5 hours before they have to leave. The traffic is a bit in favor of traffic going from Tampa to St. Petersburg instead of St. Petersburg to Tampa. And that's perhaps not surprising. That's kind of where the market is, and there's less probably market awareness of opportunities in Tampa for people in St. Petersburg and vice versa. So we are working together with marketing staff to try to create a seamless trip, buttoning together, going from the ferry terminal in Tampa, from St. Petersburg to Tampa with a seamless connection to the streetcar. And are trying to work out both the logistics and dollar amounts on that, and want to be able to market that so, in effect, a person can pick up a voucher in St. Petersburg, a streetcar voucher, that they'll get on the boat, get off, and then get on the streetcar and hand the voucher in to the operator. If we're given that there's 149 people that get off the boat in a potential time, if all of a sudden 40 people want to get on the streetcar and pay their fares, it kind of blows the schedule, and it makes it very difficult. And some of these schedules can be kind of mapped out, five different trips, combinations of ferry, streetcar, trip, where people could seamlessly go from the ferry to the streetcar, to destinations along the streetcar route. Mr. Chairman, thank you very much for authorizing a 50% reduction on that fare for ferry riders. We are trying to get private sector financing for the other half, private sector sponsorship. So you may recall or know that Frontier, for instance, is sponsoring the third Sunday rides free. And that's all. Anyone gets on, we invoice Frontier for anyone who rides it. What we're trying to do is get a corporate sponsor or a group of sponsors that will likewise underwrite the 50% of the streetcar pass.
That's great.
So we want it to be seamless. I get on, it's free to the customer. It's seamless to the customer. It's easy to use. The only people that actually would hand in the voucher and show proof of ferry trip would get on, and you would redeem the voucher through some kind of process that I guess we would figure out operationally. So what we're trying to do, though, right now is bring together the private sector piece and are working that at a couple different angles. I'm hopeful that we will have that sponsorship piece put together before the end of the year, and then we'll start marketing it over in Pinellas County. The other thing is, because of Frontier, we have $200,000 of airtime on Frontier. So if we can put together this seamless package, we have the potential to run special ads on Frontier in the Pinellas County market to say, explore Tampa. Take the ferry, take the streetcar. It's seamless. The streetcar's free. Here's how it works. Because we think part of it is just educating people in Pinellas County, in St. Petersburg, here's what you can do in Tampa.
Mm-hmm.
We fortunately have both the St. Pete Chamber of Commerce, St. Pete Clearwater Convention and Visitors Bureau, and the City of St. Petersburg, which will all help them promote that package and push it out.
That's great.
So we're just trying to kind of get that last piece together, that financial piece. It's not a big number. You know, it's maybe $1,000 a month. You know, obviously, the upside potential of this whole thing is a seamless transportation system and just building the brand and understanding about how to connect to the streetcar. So, Steve asked if I wanted to come and talk to you about what we're doing. We're working closely together and with Catherine Egan and just, you know, trying to make these pieces work.
That's great.
So, anyone have any questions or anything? Did I miss anything?
I just have some additions here. Thank you, Rita. One of the things also that we've been working, not that we don't love our downtown partnership, we've been working very closely with YCDC, and they've been putting together packages also for Friday, Saturday, and Sundays. We see more in the parks. We see more of a Sunday, more of a museum day, more of a leisurely day, which could be the Tampa Museum as well. The Museum of Art, more of a walking type of a thing. But we're concentrating on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So YCDC, the coordinator over there, is very involved as well, because we want to make the connectivity from the ferry seamless to Ybor. And that seems to be where the market would be. And that would be the interest of the St. Petersburg. One thing also, we were afforded, they do have a monitor that does run on board. And so we've supplied a PowerPoint, just a nice slide that the grid is running right now. And again, thank you, Ed, it was free.
That's terrific.
So the midday service, the commuter service, starts at 7 o'clock in the morning from St. Petersburg, then runs from, goes back to St. Pete, comes back from Tampa. That's midday. And we're going to monitor how well that's working. There's a possibility of adjusting that schedule as we go. And there's some discussion about adding more service on Sundays. We'll have the just the agreement with the city. But I think the more trips we can bring over, the better. Saturday, because we have three trips, it's just, well, Mickey and I were talking about, Mr. Jacobs and I were talking about that earlier, about how well that really works going that way, and coming this way, it works as well. And as Steve was saying, we talked to both the Florida Aquarium and the History Center about trying to build on Sundays, particularly because that starts at 11 o'clock in the morning and goes to 7.
Yeah, that's
building
good.
In cultural attractions, you know, mm-hmm. You go and go to the aquarium, go to the History Center, go to dinner, and package that all together.
So, I would think that would be very attractive.
Yeah, it's herding cats, Mike. You've been at this a long time, and you know how hard it is to get sponsorships for the streetcar and how it's. Many people benefit from it, but how do you get the resources?
Exactly.
To capture the, internalize the externality, would that be a way of doing it?
Well, it sounds possible.
So, we'll continue to work with our staff and appreciate the support of you and the board for this. And if we get into February and March and we shift to an evening service, which is a possibility, during the week. I mean,
sure.
That's going to be even more of a cause for intersection with the streetcar and have a greater potential to drive usage on the streetcar. But the things absolutely go together.
Well, we can't thank you enough for everything you've already done. So let us know how we can help, really. It's been very impressive.
Yeah, I mean, it really is. As you and I talked about it, Ed, you know, my wife and I have used it, as hopefully a lot of other people would. But we did notice on the weekend, on the Saturday in particular, that there were probably, I counted, over 20 people when we landed in St. Pete in Tampa Bay Lightning jerseys, hopping on the ferry to come over to the game. And then when we came up, when we were coming back, they were standing at the dock after the game, waiting to go back. So there's opportunities for that in terms of, you know, the special events, concerts and everything, I'm sure that, you know, we're already on top of. But I think going the other direction too, looking at ways we can connect with, you know, the discounts we have in here, with connecting with discounts over there. I mean, there's baseball opportunities. There's all kinds of opportunities, I think, in the future for it. So I'm pretty excited about it because it is pretty, it's a very easy and seamless way to get across the bay.
And fun.
Oh, it's great. Great fun.
Well, and the April schedule is held open. We proceed. That's going to be April Sports Month. So we're going to configure the schedule to make sure people from downtown Tampa can go to Rays games.
Excellent.
And then also going to configure the schedule so people can go to Lightning playoff games.
Excellent.
Hopeful. So, again, the whole point of the pilot project is to test different things.
Sure.
So the commuter piece is light. It's not, you know, it's a small market. But if you miss the first boat, you miss the last boat. That's not a real good prescription for transit. We'll see how the midday service goes. And, again, we keep on messaging that we're trying this, right? See what's going to work. And seeing how the ferry and the streetcar goes together, it's all learning. So appreciate your support, and just wanted to let you know what was going on. And, it's an absolute delight to work with the HART staff, and you've been incredibly helpful, and it's a really incredible team that we're working together, so we appreciate that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thanks, Ed.
You too. Okay, any other public input before we move on? If not, Mr. Bracken, the streetcar system performance report.
Good afternoon. I'm Greg Bracken. I'm the interim director of the streetcar operations. For the month of November, we performed 2,550.75 trips with an on-time performance of 99.8% of those completed. We had several special events during the month, 41.22 extra hours of service that was performed during that time period in November, and six Lightning hockey games were the majority of that extra service, along with the extra concerts that were out there. Met with FDOT representatives after taking over here a couple weeks ago, and walked through everything that's out there with them. And we got a good recommendation letter from them as a follow-up this week. So things seem to be going very quickly over there. A lot of projects going on at Streetcar. We started our rebuild of 428, which will have the first new air conditioning unit put on it. Probably going to be here end of January, 1st of February. So that will be kind of our pilot project there. We're also looking at new air compressor units for the entire fleet. And just keeps building on. Quite a bit of things going on. We're also working on, in conjunction with the City of Tampa, on 11 ballasted in the Southport switches. One switch is on a bad tie. It's not, you know, serious, but it needs to be replaced. So they have agreed to the repair of that, and that looks like that's going to be scheduled for January the 16th after we get through the New Year's Eve service and before we get to the Gasparilla service. So trying to impact the service as least as possible. It looks like it'll be a one-day repair, and we'll do a land bridge between the stops while the repairs are doing there to make sure that our customers are not impacted as little as possible. So, any questions?
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Legal and legislative reports, Mr. Smoker.
Two items, Mr. Chairman. The first is Fifth Amendment to the agreement with Direct Media, Inc. This agreement is identical to last year's agreement, and the only change is that the rates are still identical, but they will carry forward for 2017. So this is really informational more than anything else. The president is authorized to go ahead and sign the agreement by our bylaws, but I wanted to bring it to your attention.
And if I may weigh in, Mr. President, an issue that Mr. Smolker and I had discussed was how we came to working with Direct Media in the first place, that it was essentially a piggyback on the HART contract. And we will investigate the next time the HART contract for on-vehicle advertising comes up, instead of piggybacking with THS, actually going out with a solicitation that's all together, or just bus, or just streetcar, so we can open the door to the full competition. We'll see what we get back. But instead of asking this board to approve, 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 we can structure it so it has its own contract.
And that would occur next year sometime?
I'm not certain when the contract is up.
It is up next year.
You're
talking about HART?
The Direct Media contract?
The Direct Media contract, this is the first year of, he just renewed their contract, and this is the first year of the 3-year plus 2 1-year option.
Okay, so we'll get together with our procurement staff and see if there's a benefit to doing a modification to rolling streetcar in that officially, and then you're not approving it every year. But we'll come back to you with some ideas just to make it a little more convenient, but still maximize the money coming back in.
Okay, sure.
Or we can leave it how it is. It'll be the board's preference.
Whatever. Okay.
Yeah, we've been carrying it forward in part on the basis of the fact that we thought there was going to be a dissolution and there was no need to go back out.
Eventually there is,
competitive bidding. We've always taken the position that to try to follow the City of Tampa's procurement policies with regard to contracts, although technically our charter or bylaws require that. So in this particular instance, we've carried forward the agreement primarily as a matter of convenience, but really at some point along the way we should go back out and I think bid it.
Okay, good. And the CSX insurance renewal?
Really just an update there. I spoke with Grant Mielek, and the marketing renewal effort started in mid-November. We have 3 additional carriers who apparently are interested in providing insurance in the middle tier of this overall structure. He thinks that the pricing is going to be very competitive and that we will be ready to propose a specific program to the board in January.
Good.
And it's looking good. We might even be able to get the premium down a little bit.
Good.
So it's looking pretty good.
Good.
So we're on track.
Good. That's good news.
And other than that, I have nothing else to report.
Thanks. I don't have anything to report as chair. Ms. Egan?
I am making sure that I have nothing new from our friends at City of Tampa. Steve, is there anything that we would like to add on the Cross Bay Ferry item that Ed did not talk about? Okay. So one down. All right.
Well,
don't go too far.
I have a question about that. Does the board need to validate my...
Ratify.
Or ratify the fact that I agreed to half-price fares? Probably should.
I'd do it.
How would you frame that motion?
Motion to ratify your decision to...
To offer half-price fares as part of the Cross Bay Ferry streetcar relationship? So, anything
there
else?
It was a one-day fare.
Hmm?
One-day, all-day fare.
That's a half-price and one-day, all-day fare. Okay. So, can someone make that a form of a motion?
So moved.
Thank you.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed say nay. Thank you.
On B, the update of City of Tampa parking, I wish I had more to tell you. I actually went through a string of emails when you, I, and Karen met with Charles Domingue, and unfortunately, we have not heard back from him.
Ever?
No. In fact, I had reached out to him a couple of weeks ago as well, since the the football championship is coming to Tampa. We also heard that they are closing the garages, which is downtown. So we reached out to him to see how is he getting the word out of his regular parking people. And wanted to see, you know, if he could get the message out to them that you can park in Ybor and take the streetcar. And again, I have nothing to report.
Okay. And you never heard from McDonough?
We've done phone messages back and forth.
That's not satisfactory. It just isn't.
No, I understand.
He promised us something 2 months ago. So I'll call Bob and I'll call Mr. Dummett. And if you'll remind me tomorrow.
I'll remind you.
So we could impress the HART board chair, because I'm, you know, Councilman Suarez, we can always see if his office can assist on any response.
Well, he was a very nice guy. I don't know what his problem is. I know Bob is busy, so that I understand. But the parking guy was, we went and met with him, the guy that runs the parking, and he was all about helping us. So he's been very busy, I'm sure. I will call him tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you. On the college football playoffs, very exciting, and we're very excited about it. We've been working with the Tampa Sports Commission and also Visit Tampa Bay on this. And long story short, what I'm going to pass out is something that we're going to do on our own. They wanted us to buy a sponsorship, which would include a picture of their flag, and that would be it, with no message from us on it. So what I'm going to pass out is what we're going to do on our own.
Whose flag?
College football championship's official logo flag.
Who said no?
Good.
The one thing that I'd like to ask maybe the board again, Mr. Chair, you also authorized 200 VIP tickets at 50%, so I don't know if that needs a motion or not as well.
It probably does. So could somebody make a motion ratifying my decision to offer?
It's to the VIPs like ESPN.
250 VIP streetcar passes, three-day passes?
50% off, one-day pass.
Okay.
So moved.
All in favor say aye. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. What's very exciting about what you see in front of you, we decided to do our own. What you see on the long piece of artwork, and you'll see on the picture of Dick Greco Plaza, there are two columns when you enter and two, depending which way you go. If you look at the picture, you see the one with the plaque that says Dick Greco Plaza. There's two columns, one on each side, on both the front and the back. What we're going to be doing is putting we're going to be wrapping those columns with the creative that you see. Additionally, what we're going to be doing also is we're going to be having Welcome to Tampa banners from the streetcar at each station stop.
And you wouldn't put college football playoffs even?
They would not let us do that because they have sponsorship levels, and we had asked them for their logo specifically. And we were not allowed to do that because we're not a paying partner.
Yeah, professional sports, you got to love them. Okay, fine.
So anyway, what it does, it also, direct media was extremely helpful too, is that they are paying for part of it to help us because the sell to them is, once it's done, they can also sell it to others. They can show other people what it looks like. So that's why they're partially funding it.
Did they finally pay for anything? They were going to do wraps and things on top.
The one around the top, unfortunately, we saw a mock-up of a Bank of America around the top, and we decided that it wasn't within the current budget since it was $50,000 to wrap the entire Dick Greco Plaza, especially around the top. And the reason that it costs so much is you need a special crane to put it up. And the expense of it and the vinyl and also pressure washing. So there's a lot of work involved in installing it.
And Steve, it is hard to express how much work Steve did on trying to find anyone who had a crane and a pressure washer that would fit the bill. You did everything you could to see if we could get that idea to come up for less than $50,000.
Yes.
Okay. It would have looked great.
So that didn't work. But when we talked a month or so ago, they were going to pay for wrap. No.
Yes, actually, that's part of, since Lori isn't here and I'm going to be Lori again, I might as well be Lori. What happened is, what they brought to the table is, right now we have two streetcars fully wrapped with Northwest Mutual, and that brought in $3,600 towards THS, and one Dos Equis. Equis? I'm not a beer drinker or whatever.
It is Dos Equis.
Dos Equis. Thank you. But so they did bring in a total of $5,400. So they brought in three full wraps. What also, since I'm going to jump the gun a little bit, MillerCoors also locked up agreement for two full wraps for the year, which brings in $3,600. So the total between what the NCAA brought in, those three wraps, and the two for MillerCoors is $9,000. So I like being Lori's gauge on these days.
Yeah. Okay. So three wraps, which other people are paying for, I'm sure right. College football isn't. I mean, I saw that they went to the county commission very late in the game for an extra $1 million. So the message was they were running out of money and needed money, and Mickey would know a lot more about this than I do.
Remarkably, I'm not that up to speed on the right. This particular event.
But you do know how these things work.
I know how they work, it's all about branding and sponsoring with them and partnering.
But not paying, right?
Right. Right. Because, well, yes, they look at a community as differently than we look at them coming to us.
Absolutely.
From the economic standpoint.
Right. Okay. All right, so this is fine. I mean, this all looks great.
Mm-hmm. And the last one, since I jumped, is the New Year's Eve sponsorship. Usually at this time, we come back to you with the July 4th and the New Year's Eve. Channelside Bay Plaza does not have all the information of their sponsorship levels yet so that we can compare what we usually do with them. Last year, we sponsored free trips. We didn't sponsor. We had free trips from 7 p.m. to 1 a.m., and this year, New Year's Eve is on a Saturday. There's also a Lightning game downtown as well. So we're expecting it. Actually, we're conservative in our numbers. So what we would like to approach the board is free trips again from 7 p.m. to 1 a.m., beginning at 7 p.m. to 1 a.m. for the fireworks at Channelside Bay Plaza, along with an extra service. Since Lightning game is already till 12 midnight, we would only be extending it one additional hour, since we extended till midnight for all Lightning games. So the charge to marketing every year is about $2,500, and conservatively we're looking at about $1,000. And again, that's with a three-car frequency. However, should the crowds need more than that, that would be an operations call.
And the bottom line here is $1,000?
$1,000. $1,000 or so. It probably will be a little bit more. We're conservative in our estimate. Last year, on a Thursday, we did 6,100 trips after 7 p.m. So we're conservative. When I talked to service planning, they said just keep it the same at this point. But again, given that it's a Saturday and also a Lightning game, we think it'll do better.
It sounds like it's less expensive than last year.
Yes, because we already have extra service running for the Lightning game.
Right, okay. Mm-hmm. Rick, did you have...
Yeah, just a comment. I have no problem with doing this, but I just want the board to be aware. This function used to be done by the Attractions Association, which is a nonprofit organization, and now it's being done directly with the Bay Plaza organization, which is a for-profit organization. And I just wanted the board to be aware of that fact. So.
But you're okay
yeah,
with
I wasn't,
it?
Yeah,
I'm okay
aware
with
that. That's good to know.
Yeah, and the reason I bring it up is I know when I was on the board for Tampa Attractions Association, we also reciprocated with that organization in sponsoring streetcar events and providing dollars to this group. So just so you're aware of that.
Yeah, and just to piggyback on what Mr. Hamilton said is we're working with Daryl Winkler over there, and as soon as if the board approves us to move ahead forward with this, she is going to promote this as much as she can at this point in time.
Okay. Greg?
Yes, I just wanted to clarify one comment there. Our regular service is three cars until midnight. We'll extend until 1 o'clock. But we also are including three additional cars for the service. So it'll be a total of six cars out there for New Year's Eve.
Great. That sounds correct? Adequate? Steve, are you confused?
Yes. I understand that. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Catherine, do we need to do anything about that? Or is that just information?
I don't know that we need anything budgetary. I don't know that we need any permission.
I think
so Jeff
the board's all nodding yes, so yes.
Okay. All right.
Good. Okay. And you've already given Lori Gage's report? Okay. Okay, we have an action item, approval of the agreement between Elevate and THS. Could you walk us through that,
yes, sir.
Somebody, please?
Page 4-3 in your packet is a proposal from Elevate. Elevate is a firm here in Tampa, which does social media and targeted networking. Let me caveat this, that as we are having this conversation, HART currently has an open RFP on the street for marketing and communications. So we come to you as your staff.
Irrespective of this.
Irrespective of this, yes, sir. So we come to you as a staff trying to make sure that we can take advantage of what's going on with the college football sponsorships and Gasparilla to really get a lot of social media, but staying very clear of potential perceived conflicts of interest where vendors who may be bidding to do business with HART are now receiving a recommendation from HART staff to do business and get money from Tampa Historic Streetcar. Does it make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So Elevate not only came together with a good proposal, they are not bidding on the HART proposal. So this clears us up that there is not a, there will not be a perception that we are recommending business with them because they're doing something with another proposal for us. We just wanted to keep that clean. Having said that caveat, historically we do not spend the entire marketing budget, which goes up from THS. We routinely return money back into the bottom line every year. So once we met with the port, one of the strong factors from Paul Anderson was talking about, look at ridership development, look at this, look at that, and he had recommended Elevate as a firm that was very, that had a really good sense of what was going on with millennials and how to communicate and talk to them. And when I started speaking with Akash Patel, the president at Elevate, saying what we were looking for from the streetcar perspective, the conversation turned from just ridership development to positioning the streetcar as an asset for Hillsborough County. This is not an area that we have really focused on either for HART and or for streetcar. We have a small staff. We do not have a lot of these skill sets. So we have been missing some opportunities to get the streetcar in front of folks who aren't taking it and to highlight the role that we play or could play within the community. So we were seeking a proposal for 6 months, a pilot program, to see what this does for us on social media. How does this boost the attention coming up to Tico Street Line? And more significantly, what new partnerships can this open up? For instance, if firms in the port area are looking to do something with the community, I'm not going to know that, and our staff here is not, and the operators agreement is not articulated to empower or direct any entity to take that service over. So we're missing that. This proposal gives us the opportunity to hear about these sponsorships and talk to some of these entities and say, hey, you're looking to do something in the community. We have this fantastic streetcar line. So it opens us up for some sponsorships, and it opens us up to really just get out in front of the social media. Again, we have a golden opportunity with college football coming up. We'll have eyes from around the world, and we'll have eyes from around Tampa Bay downtown paying attention to us in a way that we don't normally get. It's clearly a different crowd from Gasparilla, but we also have Gasparilla right on the heels of this. We wanted to take advantage of this time and see what we get from going with a community partner and increasing our social media and our contact and trying to get out there to the influencers who make the decision about where transportation should be going in this community so we don't have to tell them what streetcar is doing. When it's time to put money in their budgets, they know what streetcar is doing and they understand the value. So our request today is for approval of this agreement. It's $3,000 a month for a six-month pilot program. We will come back to you with metrics and performance. So once we have data from the first month and defer to the board's decision on going for a full solicitation, which would go out on the street for a competitive bid, or not continuing the process at the end of 6 months. But again, it's a tool we just have not used in the past and very right market for us.
Mr. Chairman, I've reviewed the terms of the agreement and find them legally proper.
Comments?
I think it's a great opportunity. I think it's a way to elevate our game in telling our story in a different way than we've told it before. And so I'm excited about the potential of this because I think it's a whole new dynamic in a way of being able to tell the story and how do we make sure that we're working with Elevate in terms of getting that right story out there because there is a good story to tell. We have a unique thing going on and we... Quite frankly, I think we make decisions in here that benefits the community. The community doesn't really know a whole lot about, you know, what we do for the Lightning game, what we're doing with the ferry, all of those things. I don't think it's out into the community and penetrates as deep as it should over time. And so I really think this is a good opportunity to do that and probably reach a market that is more inclined to use the streetcar as a transportation system than typical.
Interesting. Abby, you comfortable?
I'm excited. It's a great opportunity.
Yeah. I agree, Mr. Chairman, with Mr. Jacob in move approval.
Okay. I just had one question. The addendum includes complimentary passes to be given to Elevate. It doesn't really specify how many.
I thought it said five, does it?
Oh, is that what that means?
I'm sorry, to help clarify that, what we're going to be, so that they can get used to the streetcar, rather than passes, what we're going to do is a flash pass. And we're going to put five so that they can get on.
Okay, good. Okay, so we have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed say nay. And I didn't ask you, but except we did on the phone, I assume that we can afford this in our marketing budget and it's not devastated?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Compliance reports, anyone interested in ridership or marketing report? We've heard most of the marketing. Ridership's in your file.
What you see in front of you with Joffrey's, actually World of Coffee, they approached us. And so we're doing a social media co-promotion with World of Coffee and Tea, which is also known as Joffrey's. And they approached us to get a discounted cup of coffee, especially for the morning ridership. And that's what we're pushing. So this, to me, was such a no-brainer that we're pushing it, and so are they, to the point where they will. Unfortunately, it's not cold, or fortunately, it's not cold, depending upon how you look at it. But we are also expecting one day or a couple of days to get on the streetcar and pass out coffees in the morning.
That's great. That's a great idea. Mm-hmm. Excellent. You guys have been busy.
If I could make a comment.
Sure.
Is it time to do that? On the compliance report, I think it's interesting to note the differential in incremental trips that you have when the AIDA, VITA, is in. With a group of people that typically is used to using that kind of transportation. But I think it's also important to note that our community is marketing and being successful in bringing in international events here. And I think we should really look at how do we partner or at least get the word out about that. I mean, we were just awarded a World Cup qualifier here. That's huge. And with people coming from all over the world that are used to riding a streetcar.
Thank you for mentioning that. We're already into contact with the Sports Commission.
Good.
When we saw that.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I just came back from a trip to Milan, the city would be completely gridlocked without their streetcar system. And they have a good metro, too, and it's equally busy, but their streetcar is busy all the time. It's jammed all the time. It's just the most amazing thing you've ever seen. I know you've all been to cities like that. We'll slowly but surely become a city like that. So thank you, Vicki. Is there any other business to come before us? Ms. Egan, are you good?
We are good, yes, sir.
We're good. Then I declare this meeting adjourned, and Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and we'll see everybody in January.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Happy holidays. That's great.
All right. So.